Hey everyone, this is Mel. I am back with part 3 of our note mini or small legal pad notepad holder part 3. I don't know what it's called. Whatever I named it. Last time we decided to put the covers on, put the cover magnets in, cover the spine, and build the inside as well as add the inside magnets. Today we are going to go through the matting. So, very simplistic, how do I mat? I did everything with a 1/4 inch mat is approximately right. Now, if you guys cut everything right, your base pocket here is 5 7/8 inches by 6. So you want to cut your piece of paper 5 5/8 inch by 5 3/4. And yes, that is very hard to remember and or very hard to do, but I have already done that for us. So I believe it's this side. Nope, this side. Okay. One side is 1/4 inch larger than the other. So this is what mine's going to look like. I liked this bold print for down here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add that. So today, for speed's sake, I'm going to be using snail. And that's the only reason why I'm using snail. You could use liquid glue, you could use tear tape, whatever it is. So for speed's sake, I'm using snail. I typically use wet glue. It's a little bit cheaper. Maybe close enough to the edge? I think so, okay. If you guys would like to put in like little finger holes, so like half circles, I suggest the 1 inch circle punch for that. Make sure I got this the right side up. Again, make sure you have a 1/8 inch border all the way around and go ahead and stick it down. All right, so there's that piece. Now this last piece, this next large piece over here, I do my larger pieces first and then I go ahead back in and I do my smaller pieces. So any piece that I have that is covering magnets and things, I do go ahead and I use wet glue for that. Again, I measured this. It is 5 inches wide by 9 inches tall, since it covers the entire length of your base chipboard here, which is 6 by 9. I cut it at 4 3/4 by 8 3/4. Again, always test things before. Let me actually get you guys a little bit more light here. Go ahead and test things before you actually set them down. If you don't like the size of it, you can always go back. I like the size of this. So I'm keeping that. Again, we are using the Moroccan Designer Series paper from Stampin' Up. I think it's gorgeous. It's got some really great colors in it. It's very festive. So make sure, because I have done this numerous times, I forget to pull off the backing to the tape that's holding down my magnets, which does not help them stick any better. So go ahead, make sure you guys go ahead and remove that tape. This side here is also really beautiful. I really like this blue. That was gorgeous. But I wanted to go with something that wouldn't contrast with things, so. All right, so I'm grabbing my Tombow glue here. I'm going all the way into the edges. Same thing like we did on the cover. You want a complete layer of glue, but you want a light layer of glue. And that is something that you need to make sure you have figured out. So, okay. I like wet glue also because it allows you a little more time to maneuver. In case you don't get something down 100% straight, you don't get it down exactly where you want it, it gives you a little bit more wiggle room. However, it is definitely messier. I actually have a spot right here now that I've got a little bit of glue that stuck to my fingers when I was putting things on. That's where it stuck. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my adhesive eraser and just lightly rub it over that. Go ahead and rub it. This is by Xyron. You can find it in the Stampin' Up! Catalog. I think it's awesome. It's a wonderful little adhesive remover. Okay. So those are the two ones. This piece here, so this little second note flap here. Let me see, where's my piece of paper? There it is. Okay. I cut this to be What did I cut this? You can always double check your measurements, however you guys like it. I did this 2 3/4. Okay. 1.5 inches sticks out from the top. So you at least want it 2 1/4 inches. I went 2 3/4 inches apparently. I think that was just because that's kind of sort of how it sat, I think, in the end. I did not pre-cut every piece that I have. So that should be fun. We'll see. Okay. I think I was going to use this blue side. That's right. I was using the blue side for this. This one I also use wet glue for. I cut these a couple days ago and I forgot which side I was going to use where. So I'm going to use the blue side here because I want to pull out the blues that are in here. I think they're beautiful. I think they're gorgeous. They're very bold. They make a statement and I love that about this. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and use wet glue on this too because it has to slide in somewhere. And I want to make sure it can. So go ahead and pull off the backing to the tape to your magnet. And the great thing about Stampin' Up! Paper is that both sides are typically beautiful and gorgeous. Basically everything just kind of cohesively works together. That was not always the case, and that's not always the case with every paper collection, but they have done a very good job lately of trying to make sure that things work well together. All right, so line it up, get it where you want it, make it even, go ahead and stick it down. You guys can hear my dog in the background. I do apologize. He is being very curious today. Whole curiosity killed the cat thing. It's my puppy. Okay, so while that's drying, we're going to come in here and we're actually going to, you guys remember how we had that little note card holder that's in here? We're actually going to attach everything. We're going to glue everything down on here so it has time to dry before we actually attach it into our book. Sorry, I just bumped the light. So we're going to set our book aside. So this front piece here is 3 1/4 inches, or 3 inches tall by 3 1/4 inches wide. So I made mine 3 inches wide by 2 inches tall. And I was using the blue for that. I love this blue. This blue pulls out that blue on this side as well. I think it's just gorgeous. I think it's gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Okay, then we had, let me see if I can find the other pieces here. Oh, there we go. Okay, so for this top piece, that was the inside. So for this top piece here, your top flap, your little flap here is, I believe, 1 1/4 inches. Yes, it's 1 1/4 inches. I'm gonna go close the door. My dog just opened. Hang on one. Okay, sorry about that. So this top flap here is 1 1/4 inches by 3 1/4 inches. So I made this piece here 1 inch by 3 inches. And then for the inside, I cut mine a little bit wider because I wanted to make sure it fits over that magnet, and that magnet's going to take up a little bit of space. So I cut it 1 1/4 inch, or 1 1/8, sorry, 1 1/8 inch. So you guys can see there's a smidge of a border around it by 3 3 1/8. Yeah, so 1 1/8 by 3 1/8. So it doesn't quite follow the whole quarter inch rule that I normally use. And then for the inside, I just took a piece of scrap paper that I had just to decorate the inside of the box. You're not gonna see much of it, so I didn't do the whole thing unless I had to. Again, it was just scrap from everything else that I had floating around. So again, that was 3 inches wide by however long you wanna make it. So let's go ahead and get all that put together. I'm gonna do this front flap first. And again, it's going over a magnet, so I'm using wet glue. Now, if you want to ink the edges of your paper before you do this, go for it. I kind of did a test thing for myself. I didn't really like it inked, especially in black. If I did, I would have to ink it in like an early espresso or a soft suede color. I don't think I wanted to do that. So, alrighty. Make sure you are covering your magnet adequately. There we go. Get it where you want it. And make sure you push your paper into your tape that's around it. So this piece here, this inside piece, it's not going to be holding a magnet on. I'm using snail just for speed's sake. I'm going to use the bluer side, put that out towards the top. An eighth of an inch, eighth of an inch. There we go. I'm going to use snail again for this top flat piece here because it's not holding on a magnet or anything. Get it evenly spaced. Find where you want it to put it down. There you go. Might move that. I can't tell if it's crooked or not. We all do that. Okay, so make sure you pull off your tape because this is holding down a magnet. I'm going to use wet glue. There we go. Alrighty. And line it up and stick it down. Okay, I don't think this is even, so I'm going to pull it up gently. Add just a little bit extra adhesive over the spots that didn't have adhesive correctly or pulled up a little bit of the paper. Go ahead and line it up again and stick it down. Okay. Yes, that's much better. I do think that is straight now. Okay, so we have all those pieces. Give them just a few minutes to dry. You may need to use a bone folder to really get in that glue down to the paper and to adhere. By using a bone folder, you use a lot of pressure right there and it works really well. Same thing with this side. Based on where the magnets had to wind up, you don't have a lot of space to keep it down. So, okay, set that aside for a few seconds. Pull back in your book. We're going to do this flap here. And I got two different papers to do that. So the inside piece, I'm going to be using this one here. And the outside, I'm going to be using this here. So it'll match the front of our box here. And the inside, I think I'm going to use the same paper over here. I can't quite remember. We'll have to see. Apparently I didn't cut it yet, so I meant to cut it with you guys. Okay, so this note flap here is 1 5/8 inches wide. Or four, oh my lands. Okay, trying that again. 1 5/8 inches wide. One. Okay, try this a third time. Ready? 4 5/8 inches wide. 4 5/8 inches wide. I knew I was going to get it eventually. And then this bottom part is 4 1/4. So again, 4 5/8, 4 1/4. 4 5/8, 4 1/4. I can say that three times fast. Yes, I can. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do the bottom one first, or the inside piece first. It's going to need a little bit longer to dry. So go ahead and make sure, remember to pull off your tape backing. There we go. Add some glue. I turn mine on my side, on its side, I guess I should say. Line it up, stick it down. I went with the 1/4 inch gap, so I have a piece of designer series paper that is 4 3/8 inches. I had to remember what it was. 4 inches by 4 3/8 of an inch. If your paper is directional, remember what side is what. That's all I can tell you guys. Please double check all measurements and things like that before you guys stick this stuff all down. Okay, There we go. Again, if you need to grab your bone folder to make sure it sticks down around the edge of your magnets, go ahead and do that. Which I am using my bone folder. I typically use my bone folder for this as well because it just adds a nice good pressure. That and you have that extra adhesive in there, it helps your paper to stick to that extra adhesive that's down there as well. All right, so there's that. Let's go ahead and do the top piece. I'm using snail for this piece again. So again, I'm using snail for this piece here. Okay, so let's get this lined up. And stick it down. Okay, so we need to cut a couple extra pieces. Hi everyone, I am so sorry. I had some camera problems there for a few minutes. So I just went ahead and I finished measuring and cutting. So let me go through with what I did. One more time. So I went ahead and I measured these open spaces and decided how big I wanted, how far I wanted my paper to go in and things like that. So originally I said this was going to be about a 2-inch piece by 9 inches. I actually cut that down to 1 3/4 by 9 because it's just about 1 inch from the edge of the pocket to the edge of the chipboard in there, even though you can't see it because it is part of the cardstock in there. So I went ahead and did 1 3/4 by 9. We measured this piece up here. We decided it was about 1.5 inches from the top to the very edge of the pocket. Decided to go in 3/4 of an inch, so I was at 2 1/4 by 5 5/8 inch, so it will match this piece here. I went ahead and I measured these side panels here. The smaller one here, I did a piece that is 7 8/8 of an inch by 8 7/8 of an inch. Because it's 9 inches tall, but we're not going the full 9 inches because we don't have to, I cut it down by 1/8 of an inch. Again, that's kind of where my 1/4 of an inch rule kind of sort of fell apart. this piece here is just over 1 3/8, so it's not quite a full 1.5 due to the fold, and we definitely don't want paper in the fold. So I did 1 1/4 inches by 8 7/8 of an inch. I repeated all of that. I'm going to do two pieces of each one of those for the back pieces here because you also need to cover these. So let's go ahead and get finished and hopefully no more camera problems. Okay, so we are going to quickly attach the center piece here. Now I cut this piece for the center. Originally I was going to have it be this piece, but I decided that should go here on the edge. I don't know why, because I just really liked it there, I guess. I cut another piece for the inside here, and I'll show you guys how to get that in there without having too many problems. I cut another one of this piece here for the top. Then I also cut another one of, basically this is the opposite side, just to let you guys know. I cut another one of these strips for the back or the outside of the spine piece here. And then I cut blue pieces for the outside of this side over here. So let's go ahead and get all that stuff attached. Please remember, do not stick this one down until you have your magnets in. You will have to pull it up. Put your magnets down first. So let's go ahead and get this all in here real quick. Okay, I do not have a very scientific method for doing this. I know some people say I should, but I don't. So I kind of line it up with just about 1/8 of an inch border before you get to the edge of your fold there. I grab a pencil, take it so I just can see my pocket, figure out where I want it, how I want it to lay, make sure it's all nice and straight, and I just kind of give myself a little pencil mark. I do it there, Then I do the same thing by the edge of my chipboard here. Sometimes it helps if you recrease it so you know exactly where it's at. I know basically it's going to be here. And I give myself a little pencil mark. I come in with a pair of scissors. I'm not going to snip the whole thing because I don't want very much. And I just make a nice little mark there. And I make a teeny tiny mark here. Just notching in just ever so slightly, and I angle. Find my other mark. I'm going to go from the other side just so I have a... Again, you're not notching in very much, but you're doing ever so slight of a notch. I don't know if you guys can see that. Ever so slight of a notch in there. And you're just kind of angling your pieces. That way, your piece slides in nice and pretty. There we go. So that's even. So that's how you get that in there. So I use liquid glue for this. Again, you're sliding it down into a piece. So liquid glue to me gives me a little extra time to maneuver and get it exactly where I want it. Add some glue. All right. Get it in where you want, how you want, edge to edge. Full coverage. There we go. Stick it down and give it time to dry. We're going to add this piece here as well. Quickly go through that. I will tell you the hardest part to matting is doing the last set of, the hardest part to the entire book in my mind is actually doing the last set of magnets. God knows I pull those things up at least once. So, I will not lie, it is not an easy task. Okay, again, I'm putting down the small one, but not the larger one. So the one that goes in this center panel here, or this first panel here, but not the one that goes in the panel here. Hold off on that. All right, quickly putting this in here. You guys are hearing my dog take a nap in the background. He's snoring. All right. And again, this one is 7/8 of an inch by 8 7/8 of an inch. And you definitely don't want it too close to either one of your folds. All right, so now we're going to put in this top piece here. You can definitely use this one, but it was a little bit too busy for me, so that's why I'm using the other side. At least it was a more solid color. Making sure I'm in camera range. I do forget where the camera winds up most days. Turn it around. I don't know why. Okay. Slide this in here. Now I'm going to flip my book over to make sure I'm at the edge, but not over, because I can see it this way. You may wish to do this. If you guys can lean over your table, you can do it the other way. But with you guys being able to see, I can't see. So again, I'm turning it over, just making sure it's all the way to the edge. Sorry if I'm out of camera range. There we go. I had to pull it down to where I wanted it. And then just making sure that I press firmly and get all the glue nice and stuck down, especially since you're going over a layer. There we go. Okay. Making sure the glue is all stuck down around that. Very beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Okay. There is that. Now I'm going to flip it over. I'm going to add all the pieces to my front side here. Before I continue, ooh, sorry guys, I just bumped my light. I think I'm actually going to go with the same pattern. You can always go with the reverse pattern if you wish. But I think I'm actually going to go with the same pattern because I kind of like that look today. I don't know why, but I do. you're allowed to change your mind. Originally, I thought I was going to use this side here, the more aqua side, not the pattern side, or what I'm calling the pattern side. But I decided to change my mind. I'm allowed. I'm a girl, right? All right. Light but full coverage on your glue. I'm aiming for the center. Now I did 7/8 of an inch on here because you have that quarter inch gusset on each side. And I just wanted to look nice and pretty. Again, I left about 1/8 of an inch off. So you have a 16 and a 16th of an inch. Okay, we're gonna put on these front flaps. These can both go on. Make sure I'm even, nicely spaced. And again, I'm using wet glue. I started out with the snail, but for some reason I apparently switched because the wet glue just happened to be handier. I don't know. I normally use wet glue. Anything that requires me to be absolutely straight, or I want to be absolutely straight, I have a tendency to stick with wet glue. But ATG works just as well. Snail works as well. Basically anything that you guys like to use. If you guys want to use your score tape, go ahead and use your score tape. That works as well. I just have problems lining things up, so I don't use it right out the door. Okay, so there we go. Beautiful, right? Now comes a couple of the hard parts. We're going to put together. Now that this piece here is dry, we're going to put it all together. Where is, there it is. So take off your adhesive back on these, your tabs here. And then just fold in your cut edge to your folded edge. So you want to take this innermost one, fold edge to cut edge. Same thing here, folded edge to cut edge. Turning this over, pulling off the tape backing there. Hardest part about this entire thing is getting this lined up right. Make sure it's in that fold and then stick it down. We're going to go back through with your bone folder in just a second to double reinforce the adhesive stick, but just give it just a second here. Get both sides done. Fold it in. Cute. Okay, we're going to move the book out of the way for just a moment, preferably without me hitting the light so you guys can actually see. My grid paper started moving. So I turn it backside down again, and then I just run my bone folder in nice firm pressure over where you stuck that together just to ensure the stick. Okay, I come back in with tape. Now, can you sit here and go like this and be really nice and precise about it? Yes. I personally am not. Actually, I'm gonna go up and down first. Just because I don't like to smash my box. I have found that if I do that, I sometimes accidentally smash the box, and I don't want to smash the box. That's also the hardest part about putting in the magnets, is that you have to be careful not to dent your box. Put another one here. Yeah. I'm not making this perfect, but at the same time, I'm making sure I have plenty of coverage in order to withstand the abuse that I'm going to give it. And there we go. Again, I just snipped off whatever is extra. To me, it was okay. It was better than smashing the box. Okay. Now, I always close my lid first. So once you have your box together, you notice you have a beautifully closed lid. Again, I turn it over, run my bone folder back there just to ensure the adhesive stick. It's not going to come up. Peel off the backing to your tape. Second to last, or third to last step. So this is three more steps, including getting this on. There it goes. Okay, close your lid. Pull back in your book. Maybe four steps left. I forgot, we gotta ink the edges. And then you just line it up at the bottom, get it nice and straight. I go side to side, center to center. And let's see, I'm gonna stop talking for just a second, guys. Okay, line it up where you like it. Go back in and burnish your adhesive down. All right. Okay. Now you guys want the hard step? I think we need to do the hard step next. So put in a notepad. These are just the mini legal pad, notepad, small legal notepads. They're about 5 3/4 inches wide, or five inches wide. I think they're 5 inches wide. Yeah, they're 5 inches wide by 8 inches tall. They're standard here in the US. They slide in to here. Let's go ahead and stick in a magnet while we're at it. Ugh, forgot. Let's go ahead and do the magnet while we're thinking about it. Okay. Put on your magnet. Again, I use a glue dot. For me, a glue dot works perfectly well. I don't have any problems with it. I haven't had any problems with it. Just make sure you ensure the stickage. Slide in your notebook cover to where you want it. Press. And you should come off with it right on the back. So there you go. So when you slide it in again, it will adhere down, not flap around in case it gets turned over in your notepad holder or in your briefcase or wherever you put it. Okay, so again, you want to make sure your notepad holder is in there before you start this next process. It helps with sizing. That's all I can say. It helps with sizing. Okay, grab yourself your last three magnets. Sorry, I have them on my light pole, as I said. Oops. One, two, three. I'm grabbing three more glue dots, putting them on top of the magnets. You guys probably can't see the glue dot, but I'm placing the glue dot on top of the magnet. You can use, and if you guys don't have glue dots, go ahead and use score tape. That works as well, but you want something that's actually going to stick and stay. Now the hardest part. I check a couple of times, so you want to make sure that the edge of your notepad holder is up against this crease here or just below that crease there. So you want that, you want it to fold 100% over. You want to make sure you are flush with the table on both ends. Sit there and stick it down. The hardest one is that one in the middle. The hardest one is the one in the middle. As you guys can see, I am moving my book multiple directions to make sure I get them all in there. And I totally moved my grid paper. I'm so sorry, guys. Okay. So I can see I have them all down, right? you think they're in the right spot, go ahead and test. Make sure they're in the right spot. You're gonna wanna see when you guys turn it, you guys can see a little bit of a gap. You guys probably can't see this here, but you're gonna see a little bit of a gap in there. That is where your magnets are at. You can definitely tell if they are engaging or they're not engaging. So if they're not, you need to move them. Amazingly enough, you know, I said it always takes me 2 tries to do this. I got it on the first try. I don't know how that happened. But, which is crazy. Now, the longer you have those magnets sitting against each other and working with each other, the better they're going to stick. I don't have a good reason as to why. So make sure you go back in with your score tape and put a piece of score tape over each and every one of them. So this is also why I have a 7/8 of an inch spacing on my last piece here. So there. And my last one. There we go. So we're going to burnish down that tape real good around the magnets real quick. You don't want these magnets to be moving. Go ahead and check them again. I am paranoid. I double, triple, quadruple check all of my magnets all the time. Okay. Now I will tell you, with the score tape backer on there that says Sook Wing on it, it doesn't like to stick because that piece of paper is thick and filmous and has a couple of extra things on it. So the stick is not nearly as good, but double check to make sure that everything's in the right spot. Pull it off. Again, I like to use glue dots because if those things were not put in the right spot, it's a little bit easier to pry off a glue dot than it is to try to pry off score tape. So last but not least, add your last piece of designer series paper. Make sure I've got adequate glue coverage. And I'm going to make sure I get this thing 100% covered adequately, properly. Okay, there's that. Go back in with my bone folder, work my way around my magnets again. So as I said, you can actually stick your magnets a bit further into your front cover. As it turns out with this one, I didn't need to go quite so close to the edge. That's okay. There we go. All right. There. Quickly, I'm going to add in my pen while we're thinking about it, or while I'm thinking about it. I actually go and I grab whatever the cheapest pen I have is. The cheaper the pen, I found out, the better it sticks. Don't ask me why. You're also going to go grab a little bit of Velcro. You guys don't have to put in a pen. I put in a pen. I lose mine all the time. I use a little bit of Velcro here. These are just Velcro squares. I wound up actually stealing the original for my first project out of my mom's sewing stuff. However, I have gone and bought Velcro squares since then because I've made so many of these. I take a Velcro square, or circle. Sorry, it's a circle. It's a Velcro circle. You cut it in half. These are pre-adhesive Velcro circles. This is what I use. I do one half at a time. I use the clear ones, so, or they say clear on them. I don't think they're actually clear. I put one right about there. I do the other half. I put both pieces on the pen first, and then I stick it to the book. I will tell you that these pre-adhesive Velcro circles do stick to some pens better than others. As I said, the cheaper the pen, the better it sticks. Don't ask me why. Like, I have these Sharpie pens. It sticks to the cap real well. However, I really should have split it. This is my prototype pen, actually. That's in my book that I use. That I made a couple of changes before I got to this format. One full circle isn't enough to hold on your pen. Anything that has a cap, I'm not sure I would suggest. Because you have to make sure that the cap and the whatever Velcro piece is down here to hold it in place has to be lined up all the time. So, things I've learned. Okay, I pull off the back to the second half. All right, there we go. And I always aim for the upper half because the thicker part of the pen is always the top part of the pen. And you, for whatever reason, do not want to run into this piece down here. Line it up where I want it, stick it down. Now the first time pulling it off, be careful. Didn't get the second one stuck down, okay. Stick that back. Stick that back in there. There we go. So the first time you stick it down and you pull it up, you want to be careful because then you can go back in and you can press really well on here as well as really well on here. Just press, press, press until that adhesive gets stuck in there. Press, 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 and your pen and things are now well adjusted. So you have all of the outside pieces done. The only thing left that you need to do is ink all of your edges. Now, if your book is like mine and just kind of popped open a little bit, turn it upside down tonight or tomorrow and put something flat and has to cover the entire thing. I actually typically use a pack of paper or something like that and lay it flat on top. It just helps that these magnets engage a little bit better. So I'm going to pull my pen out to be on the safe side momentarily. Now I use Stampin' Up's Archival Basic Black Ink, and you can do this with a sponge, though I found it to be a lot faster if I just take the ink pad and go directly to the chipboard. So I take the ink pad directly to the chipboard, doesn't hurt my ink pad, doesn't hurt my chipboard. that, and it doesn't take me nearly as long. Now, if you find that you have like itty bitty corners, you may want to go in with a sponge later on. I do the top. I do this over a piece of scratch paper because when you turn it over, it's going to leave black marks. So FYI, it will leave black marks. And your hands are going to get a little bit inky and all that kind of fun jazz. All right. Get it nice and inked up there. I get it nice and inked up here. Ooh. Not bad. Okay. Sorry if my arm was in the camera range there. Okay. Set that down. Last but not least, do this. As I said, I take my pad directly to it. Just keep going along. Get it to the desired level of inkiness as you would like. As I said, this is going to take it a few minutes to dry. You guys can see my hands are a little bit inky. For this back piece, fold all the way down. And then take your ink pad and do the same thing. Alrighty. As I said, much faster than trying to do it all. So if you guys if you guys are using wet glue or anything like that, I'm going to put back my grid paper. I do apologize for it moving so much. You guys have any little extra residual adhesives or anything, go ahead and grab your heat. And then you guys can decorate it however you want. A couple of things I would suggest. Watch your dimension. If this is sitting on your desk, that's one thing. If it's going into a briefcase, a purse, that's a totally different thing. You don't want so much dimension that you can't get it in there or it's gonna smash the book or whatever you're looking at. Next thing is you wanna make sure that you don't cover up your magnet. You guys can always do up the insides. I hope you guys enjoyed my tutorial. This is Mel from Cardstock Concoctions saying, I really hope to see you guys again soon. If you liked this video, go ahead and please like it. If you actually like the project, go ahead and like. If you'd like to see more projects like this, please go ahead and subscribe and definitely comment. I love to hear you guys. I love to see, if you guys make one of these, I would love to see a copy of it, picture of it. Send it to me. I love to see what you guys create. I guess that's it for today. I hope to see you guys again soon. This is Mel saying, see you guys next time. Bye.